When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll.
This is a good day, and we're here with friends. And it's a wonderful opportunity for Joey's family to say thanks to a community who has been here for them for many years.
In honor of your beautiful bride and in memory of her, I want to present you with this letter jacket with Joey's name on it. It's for you.
Thank you.
Yes. Yes.
And I want to take this opportunity to thank the hundreds and thousands of people in this little town. I wouldn't have wanted to come from any other town than this town, because your outpouring of love and grace and mercy personified the people that you truly are. She loved you because you had believed in her. You never gave up in her. You knew that she had a dream.
A few months ago, Pastor Jerry, I was at his service, and I did something. Here they are, okay. I did something. I got saved. Yeah. I went and saw Joey that night. She said, "Dad, something happened today, didn't it?" She was grinning from ear to ear. And I said, "Well, yeah, I guess, you know." And she said, "You got saved." And, I mean, it was a special day for me, but it was really special to her. The only thing I got to say is, I'm so blessed to be the one she called Dad.
I'll be satisfied as long as I walk. Let me walk close to thee.
I will forever be thankful for the past 5 months. Joey's has taught me so much about myself I never saw. About love, about living, and about sacrifice. So thank you, Rory, for allowing Joey to stay here. And thank you, community, for loving us, supporting us, and showing compassion to our family. And as this grieving process continues for the rest of our lives, I will continue to praise and trust Jesus. Live life to its fullest and leave my mark. And one day, I will be reunited with both Joey and Justin.
I want to thank God for the witness of this beautiful woman, and for this the witness of this family, the courage, the strength, the faith, the things that she taught us through it all. Community, thank them for what God has done.
I would like to thank this little town of Alexandria, Indiana, Joey's town, the place where her family settled generations ago, and when it came her time to take their place, it's the place where she took her first breath, and 40 years later, where she took her last. Thank you for loving her and for loving me. Thank you, Bill and Gloria, Mom and Dad, Jody, Julie, and Jesse. Thank you to everyone here and around the world who have followed our journey and have shed a million tears. and prayed 1,000 prayers for someone that you have never even met. Joey felt your love. And here in this moment, we feel it now. We will take it with us and walk on, me and our little Indiana and Heidi and Hopi and all of Joey's family. Lastly, I want to thank my beautiful bride, Joey, for choosing me and giving me the greatest gift that I've ever had. Her love. She may have played basketball and volleyball in this gym, and I may be wearing her jacket, but what she lettered in was love. Thank you.
Today in this community that gave birth to this amazing soul, we've come together to say not only goodbye, but thank you. Thank you, Joey, for reminding us of the real life and faith and trust that on our best days we hope we gave to you. May the truths you insisted on leaving with us, the hymns that gave you courage and strength, sing their way back into our souls on the days when hope seems in short supply and hidden in the mist of cynicism, and we have lost our trust in God and each other. Thank you, Joy, for confirming in our hearts that love is stronger than hate, joy will conquer fear, and that sunshine and rain are both necessary and better than we think, if rainbows are ever to appear.
My good friend would say to his friends and those who departed, I'll see you at the house. It's pretty good, isn't it? Could we all today say, Joey, I'll see you at the house. Let's say it. Joey, I'll see you. One more time. Joey, I'll see you at the house.